We often hear about OLEDs, but what are OLEDs? OLED means organic light emitting diodes. They are small diodes which emit light. Their emissive layer is made of organic molecules, namely molecules with carbon and hydrogen, but also nitrogen and oxygen. A diode is an electronic component which allows the one-directional flow of electricity. However, how OLED is made? OLED consists of several overlapping layers between one cathode and one anode. Inside this stack, there are some layers to improve the charge transport. However, the most important layer of OLEDs is the emissive layer, because this is where the production of light occurs. Indeed, by applying an external voltage, positive charge and negative charge, named electrons, are created. Electrons migrate toward the anode. When electrons are back to the emissive layer, they are in the excited state of the molecule with higher energy. When they return to the ground state with lower energy, they emit the difference in energy in the form of light. This is the light generated by OLED. With the correct design of organic molecules, we can modulate the difference in energy between the excited state and the ground state so that we can have emission in the blue, green, and red region. Even if OLED technology looks new, we are already at the third generation. The first generation of OLEDs were the fluorescent OLED, based on fluorescence emission. However, these devices achieved only 25% of internal quantum yield. After this stage, we have moved to the phosphorescent OLED, with quantum yield from 75 to 100%. Nowadays, it seems that phosphorescent OLEDs have been displaced by the most promising thermally activated delayed fluorescent OLEDs. But in the end, what is the difference from the LED displays? First of all, OLEDs allow to eliminate the backlight of LED technology, the LCD sheet and the RGB filters. Everything is replaced by only one sheet made of various and minute OLED lights in the red, blue and green region. Other advantages of OLED are the intense black color and the possibility to have thinner and brighter displays, as well as flexible displays.